Today I will demonstrate load balancing using OpenDaylight as the SDN controller. First we will start the controller and wait for a few seconds for it to get ready. Before we run our topology on Mininet, let's go through it. The topology supported by the program is factory topology and the program works dynamically on any host. However, we will be concentrating on host 1 and host 4 for this example. Pay close attention to the ports and switch IDs of this topology. Switch IDs have been specified in decimal and hexadecimal as some controllers convert it to decimal and some convert it to hexadecimal. Now we will run the topology on Mininet on port number 6633 as open flow communication will take place on this port. Next we do a ping all to ensure that all links are up and running. While that is happening, we will check the graphical user interface of OpenDaylight to get better insight of what the topology looks like. Few packets may be lost initially during the ping all command, so we will do ping all a couple of times. To give a real simulation feel of load balancing, we will ping host 1 and host 3 in order to get the links to start transmitting the data. Next, we will run the script and specify the host between which we want to perform load balancing. The third parameter is optional and it doesn't matter which host you provide as input in the third parameter. Once the input has been provided, the scripts perform REST request to get several information. This includes host IP and host MAC mapping, host and switch mapping, host and switch port mapping, and switch to switch port mapping of links. Like for example, switch 11 is connected to switch 17 from port 3 of switch 11 to port 2 of switch 17. The program makes use of Dijkstra's algorithm to get the shortest routes for the two hosts. This avoids making use of longer paths and limits computation to few paths. As OpenDaylight doesn't provide current transmission rate, subsequent requests have to be made to get current transmission rate. This adds latency to the program. The path with least transmission rate is selected as the best path and flow rules are inserted in switches present in the best path. We can check the flow rules by performing a REST request. Observe that there are two flow rules inserted for each switch. One is from host 1 to host 4 and other is from host 4 to host 1. Observe the input and outputs as those are one of the most important flow matching parameters in the flow rule. To see if this truly works, we will ping H1 and H4. Next, we open Wireshark and check switch 1, port 4 for traffic of host 4. We won't be able to see traffic of host 4 on this interface, as the flow rule clearly says choose port 3 of switch 1. On shifting to port 3 of switch 1, we will be able to see the host 4 traffic on this interface. However, what about host 3 traffic? Well, by default, OpenDaylight forwards traffic to all the ports. So we will be able to see traffic of host 3 on all ports. To avoid this, we can have some flow rules inserted in the switches. However, given the current scenario, we have shown how we can perform load balancing in OpenDaylight using load-based load balancing policy. And that's it with this demo. I hope you liked it.